Number 420.
Let us build a house where love can
dwell, and all can safely live, a place where saints and children tell how
hearts long to forgive. Rock of faith and heart of grace, love of Christ shall end division. Jesus, all are welcome, all are welcome,
all are welcome in this place.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
us pray. Almighty ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul and Barnabas continued on from Perga and reached Antioch in Pisidia. On the Sabbath, they entered the synagogue and took their seats. Many Jews and worshipers who were converts to Judaism followed Paul and Barnabas, who spoke to them and urged them to remain faithful to the grace of God. On the following Sabbath, almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord. When the Jews saw the crowds, they were filled with jealousy and with violent abuse contradicted what Paul said. Both Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly and said, "It was necessary that the word of God be spoken to you first, but since you reject it and condemn yourselves as unworthy of eternal life, we now turn to the Gentiles. For so the Lord has commanded us, 'I have made you a light to the Gentiles, that you may be an instrument of salvation to the ends of the earth.'" The Gentiles were delighted when they heard this and glorified the word of the Lord. All who were destined for eternal life came to believe, and the word of the Lord continued to spread through the whole region. The Jews, however, incited the women of prominence who were worshipers and the leading men of the city, stirred up a persecution against Paul and Barnabas, and expelled them from their territory. So they shook the dust from their feet in protest against them and went to Iconium. The disciples were filled with joy and the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Sheep of his flock.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, had a vision of a great multitude which no one could count from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. Then one of the elders said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes. They made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they stand before God's throne and worship Him day and night in His temple. The one who sits on the throne will shelter them. They will not hunger or thirst anymore, nor will the sun or any heat strike them. For the Lamb, who is the center of the throne, will shepherd them and lead them to springs of life-giving water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Cleanse my heart and my lips, Almighty God, I may proclaim your gospel worthy and well. In the Father, the Son, and the Spirit.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Says the Lord, "I know my sheep, and mine know me."
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. No one can take them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all, and no one can take them out of the Father's hand. The Father and I are one." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, good morning, everybody. And a happy Mother's Day to all of our mothers who are here. I found the perfect Mother's Day card, and I will give it to my own mother later today. And it's got a picture of this kid on the front who is up to no good. And it says, "Mom, I remember when I was little and running away seemed like the only option." Then you open it up. "I'm glad you didn't." Isn't that great? Happy Mother's Day and a thank you to all of our mothers, especially those who didn't run away, because I'm sure the temptation is there. But I will pray the church's prayer over all of our mothers later in this Mass after the petitions. I just have a quick little thought for each of the readings. The first reading, we hear about Paul and Barnabas and how they, how all of these people in Antioch just start flocking to hear them. Why? Because they're talking about God. They're talking about Jesus and what they have seen Jesus do. And it says that almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord as Paul and Barnabas boldly proclaimed it. And you know, Paul and Barnabas were being faithful to what's called the Great Commission. It's the commandment of God to preach Christ, to talk about Christ, and to model the Christian life very well as well, but to talk about God. And I think maybe just a little question, like, when was the last time I talked about the Lord to someone? And maybe it's not always easy to do it, but boy, does it open up grace and conversions. One of our fourth graders at St. Joe, one of our middle schoolers at Shelbyville Middle School was telling me that this kid who's in fourth grade at St. Joe got on the bus, and he said, that kid was talking about God for 30 minutes on the way home. And I said, amen, that's good. Because who can, like, that's awesome. Like, if people want to hear, it's just, we need to do that sort of thing. And it doesn't always have to be that, you know, like, I'm going to talk to you about God. But like, one of our high school girls, she's an artist, and she was in the art competition at Shelbyville High School. And each one of these kids had a booth with their artwork. And she had several pictures of Jesus and Mary. And there's a way of preaching. There's a way of talking about God in a beautiful way. And so the Great Commission. The second reading, the line that really got me was this bit about God will wipe away every tear from our eyes. And when we're struggling, when we have sorrows, we have a God who specializes in wiping away tears and consoling us. And we go to God for that. It's so important when we are struggling and when we're in difficult moments, stressed out. It talks about the time of great distress and all this. Like, when we're dealing with heavy stuff, we don't go to the bottle or to the internet or whatever. We go to Christ, and He will wipe away those tears. And then the second piece of that is that sometimes we're the instrument of that, you know? Mothers do that in a beautiful way. They love to wipe away the tears of their children, no matter how old their children get. I was thinking, too, of David Byer, and how there was a young man who, anytime anybody was struggling with something, he could tell who was having a bad day. And he'd come up and say, Father, go talk to so-and-so. She's really sad. I can tell. And he would go and he would try as best he could to wipe away tears from people's faces. And maybe it's just a good question. Am I causing tears in others, or am I wiping them away? We want to contribute to the healing of the world, the healing of people, the consolation, and not the hurt. It can be a very sad thing to cause another to cry. And we've probably all said things and done things, and we look back and we realize the hurt that brought to somebody. And maybe there's a lot of things we don't even realize that, you know, and we know what others have done to us that have made us to be hurt and caused our own tears. But we want to be people who, like Jesus, actually Jesus through us, wiping away tears, contributing to the healing of this broken world. The gospel is just a happy little short one, and it reminds us that we have a good shepherd. It's Good Shepherd Sunday, and we have a good shepherd, and we don't have to figure life out by ourselves. Isn't that good news? We just have to follow the good shepherd, and he's not going to ever lead us to a bad road. In fact, our gospel, Jesus reminds us, I'm taking you to heaven. Just follow me. That's where I'm going to lead you. And all the way to heaven is heaven for the one with Jesus. And we stick with him. That's where we end up, but we get a lot of heaven along the way. And he says that no one can take us out of his hand. That's how strongly a hold he's got. Now, we got free will, so we can leave if we want. But there's no force on earth and none in hell that can pluck us out of God's hand. And so he's the good shepherd, and he leads us to heaven. Our trick is, am I listening to him? Am I listening often, daily, to the good shepherd? and seeking direction from him on how to live my life, what decisions to make. Because if we don't listen to the Good Shepherd, we're probably listening to somebody else, and it's probably not our friend. So let us ask God today, as we celebrate our mothers, let us ask our blessed Lord, the Good Shepherd, to keep us always journeying towards him, who will wipe away all the tears from our eyes, and who does do that. And praise God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us profess the faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now in faith, let us turn to God and lay our needs before him.
For all who shepherd the church, especially Pope Francis, Archbishops Thompson, and Father Mike, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may rely on the Holy Spirit's strength as we face challenges and negative messages in our work and society, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are graduating this season, that they will have the courage and wisdom to make good decisions for their future, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers, that God will bless and strengthen them and inspire us to greater love by their witness of love and concern, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peacemakers, that the Holy Spirit will inspire all who are working to end violent conflicts around the world, especially in the Ukraine, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
During this Mass, we remember all the mothers who have passed away, and Mike Beyer, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Let us pray the church's prayer over our mothers. If your mom is next to you, put your hand on her shoulder. Gentlemen, if your children are adults and not here, and you're next to your bride, put your hand on her shoulder. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women, that they may be strengthened in their vocation as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect and love. Grant your blessing upon them, dear Lord, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us show our mothers how much we love them. You can be seated now as the altar is prepared.
Our next obituary song is 695, Saint of Mary.
Cleanse me from my sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy Every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Vincent de Paul, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Charles, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Wyatt, peace be with you. Peace, Jessica. Seed of your body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not bring me to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy be for me protection of my body and a healing remedy. Okay. Have mercy on us. You take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. God bless you always. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ.
Our communion song will be 394, Here I Am, Lord.
Body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
May God bless you all. May God bless you all. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. May God bless you. Body of Christ.
Amen.
May God bless you always. May God bless you always. The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. God bless you always, body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May God bless you always. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May God bless you always. May God bless you always. The body of Christ. May God bless you always. May God bless you always. God bless you always. Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. May God bless you always. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. May God bless you always. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. May God bless you always. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Thank you. I'm running low. May God bless you, body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. Thank you. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. May God. Oh, body of Christ. Bless you. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
There is no KFC chicken dinner today, but there will be one next week, and that's in connection with the St. Joe Festival, which is next Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
That's right.
And Sunday. And speaking of that, Kristen Shetmer will be by the main door of church selling raffle tickets for St. Joe's raffle. Also, there are baby bottles by the doors of church. You may take one of those and fill it for the support of Clarity, which provides many services for pregnant women and families and babies. And we ask you to try to remember to bring it back on Father's Day. And so happy Mother's Day to all the women who are mothers.
Amen. Amen. Well, blessings to all. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Our closing song will be number 434, Though the Mountains May Fall.
And those. Though the mountains may fall.
the mountains may fall, the hills turn to dust, the love of our God is at hand. Dust, yet the love of the Lord will stand, and a shelter for all who will call on your name, sing the praise and